Right, yeah, we have started the recording. Yeah, now you can. I already started the recording. All right, guys, it's 11:08 a.m. So we have given 8 minutes for the people who are facing technical glitches, and we are back. Good morning to all. So I welcome to this event or a presentation on digital marketing. Thanks to the management of Bhadruka, and special thanks to Mr. Rishi, and thanks to all the student coordinators who helped us in what you call together in promoting this particular session. So before we start this particular session, there are a few things that I wanted to tell to you guys. First is we are using not a meeting tool. In Zoom we have a meeting tool. Along with that, we also have a webinar tool. Right now we all are connected to webinar tool. So we all are connected to webinar tool. So this is all one way communication, so that to not to get interrupted with the voice of others. So automatically all the presentees or attendees voice is automatically there. It is muted. So you people cannot talk to the panelists directly. So as we are using webinar, because the count of students is more than 50 right now, so there could be a disturbance. So it is in auto mute mode right now. So during this particular session, if you have any queries or you want to ask something, there is always an option called Q&A. So you can see on your screen or on your mobile, you can find that option called Q&A. You can click on that particular option and then you can put all your questions, whatever you want. So last 15 minutes we have time. In the last 15 minutes, I'll be taking questions one by one. Then I will start answering all your queries. So do not post the queries in the chat box. We have a separate box called Q&A, that is question and answer box. You can post it over there. So 15 minutes at the end, we'll be spending only on question and answers. Next, when you look at this particular session, this session is segregated into three different sections. The section number one for first 10 to 15 minutes will be very, 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 very basic, which you already know it, which you people are already familiar with. After 15 minutes, we'll move into intermediate. Intermediate, you might be knowing or you may not be knowing. After that could continue for next 30 to 20 minutes. After that, again, we have another 30 minutes of session. And there we are going in depth into digital marketing. So first we'll go with basic. Then once you people get used to it, then we'll go to intermediate, and then we'll move into what advanced section. Yeah, and then right, so this is all about what the session. At any point of time, in case if my voice is not audible or you people cannot see my screen, or if there is any disturbance, because as this is not a classroom training, because we are taking it through online, so we don't know, maybe there could be a power fluctuation here or internet fluctuation, I do not know. In case if there is a delay, what we can do is we can pause this session for a while and then we can continue as well. Next important thing is, like, in case if your people are missing this particular session due to any technical difficulties, you need not have to worry. At the end, we are also recording this particular session. This session will be uploaded to YouTube, and you can get we will forward you the link. You can watch it over YouTube as well, in case if there is a glitch if your people are facing. Next, at the end of this session, we'll also give you the feedback form. People, whoever fills the feedback form, because that feedback has to be submitted to the management. So whoever fills the feedback form, the college management and together Digital Nest, along with the Google logo, you will be getting a participation certificate for the people who are attending this particular session. And all the attendees right now, all how many minutes you people are staying in the session, at what time you entered, at what time you are exiting, your entire attendance report also will be shared to the management for generating the certificates. So this is all about set of rules and regulations of this particular session. So now quickly, let us not wait any further. So there's a time constraint, there's a lot to teach. So let us move into the subject, right? So meanwhile, first, the agenda of this particular session is introduction of speaker, introduction of the company, what is digital marketing, techniques and tools involved in digital marketing, live case study taking any two business verticals, how to acquire a customer, how to retain a customer, how to nurture a customer using various digital marketing techniques, how to earn money via blogging, how to do lead generation, how to do lead nurturing, what are lead conversion techniques, various certifications that are involved in digital marketing, what are the careers in digital marketing, what are the certifications in digital marketing, what are the packages in digital marketing that companies are offering. Then we'll have a question and answer session and thank you note by the speaker. And this particular session is not meant only for finance or HR or anyone. Everyone across any vertical can understand this session, and it's very easy. Even a 8th standard student or 10th standard student also can learn digital marketing. And irrespective of what field you people are from, one or the other way you will be meeting digital marketing in your daily life. So that's how that's the importance of digital marketing actually. Now let us quickly move into about me. So I'm the speaker. My name is Sandeep Reddy Santosham. So I am the founder and the CEO of Digital Nest, where I founded this business when I was in BTech second year. So in the second year itself, I registered a private limited company. First, I was into event management. Then I started an educational consultancy where I used to sell management quota seats. After that, then I printed books called What After 10th, What After Intermediate when I was in fourth year of BTech. I was not interested in BTech. I was interested in business. But how in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, at that point of time, 4 or 5 years ago, the son boleto, they'll put you into Narayana. Daughter boleto, they put into Sri Chaitanya in some campus. And then MSET, AIEEE, IIT, this was the fashion. But my interest was not that. Some or the other way, I am not that matured, or my parents are not matured. I also gone into BTech, but I was not interested in BTech. So instead, what I was doing is, I was interested in business because I was managing my father's business when I was in when I was in my 10th intermediate or during my school days as well. But BTech, the coding is like Tari Zameen for me. I was not interested at all. So I thought I did a wrong step. Let me do something which is interesting. And I was not going to college, but somehow the other way I got 87% by writing examinations or whatsoever. I asked my dad, I need a computer to do C programming. He said, do you want to code? I said, my college management is asking me to buy a computer. And then finally I got a computer. Not even a single day I have installed C language in that. From morning to evening, I was playing games or I was watching movies or I was doing something different from what others are doing. Like me, there might be many people in the market who are facing this pain. Like after 10th, they don't know what to do. After intermediate, they don't know what to do. And I created a blog when I was in BTech first year itself. And that blog, I used to write content. What are the fashion courses? What are business courses? Commerce courses? What after 10th? What after intermediate? I used to collect information in the form of articles and I used to put in the form of a website. At that point of time, there is no word called digital marketing. There's nothing like this. But generally, without knowing, I used to collect information so that anyone can read. That was like a service to other students. I used to collect the information. Apart from that, then I felt that this BTech is not working. Let me do MBA. And that's where I went to in the second year of BTech, third, fourth, all the 3 years. All the 3 years I have gone for CAT coaching in Time Institute. I went for Career Launcher. Then I also went to IMS. But I didn't crack CAT. Instead, I cracked MAT. So my MAT percentage was 96. But I know until and unless we get a good percentage in CAT, you will not get into the reputed B schools. But somehow the other way through MAT, there was a college in Bangalore called Future Innoversity, which is started by Big Bazaar, Pantaloon, these people, their company, they started a college. And then I had enrolled into a program called MBA in Supply Chain Management. So our college was completely different. 3 days we are supposed to work for the Future Group. We had to go to Big Bazaar, godowns, we had to go to warehouses, and we have to practically do everything what is taught in the class. Apart from that, we have to also work in the store for 3 days. In the 3 days, they might put you anywhere, we don't know. Whether I might be into Central, I might be into Pantaloons, I might be into Big Bazaar, or I have to go to the warehouses and work. Only 3 days we used to have classes, rest 3 days we are supposed to work for the company. So it's a mix of practical and theoretical thing. But supply chain was not interesting me because I was blogging. I used to collect, during my BTech, I used to collect CAT question papers, MAT question papers, all the BTech relevant projects and all. My blog was actually becoming famous, and without knowing to me, I myself put Google ads on my website, and I used to make money through what? Through advertisements on my website, through my blogging. So somehow or the other way, I came to know, oh, this is what digital marketing is. Okay, we can earn some money. We can take our website to top in Google so that we'll get clicks and people will come to our site. I saw, without knowing to me, I started learning through some blogs, through videos and others. And finally, I myself turned into a digital marketer. Now, how did I turn into digital marketer? One side, I was planning, I was managing my blog. Other side, I started a publication company called for printing books. To sell those books, I created a website, and I used to promote a lot in social media. And then in MBA first year, when I was in Bangalore, I am already an MBA student. At that point of time, looking at all the activity that I was doing in the college, so a Creative Neurons Bolke, Indian origin company, which is in Singapore, they invited me to become a trainer in their institute in in Singapore, but I have to take all the classes online. So whatever the practical part I was doing, I should teach them. So along with that, Creative Neuron, I mean, those institute people also told me these are the skills that you people have to groom. And then finally I groomed. And then I was having a lot of debts on my head. My father has gone into coma. And when I was in MBA first year, there were 40 lakhs debts. And I couldn't go for campus placement because I was not interested in job first. Apart from that, there is a lot of turbulence in the family. So then I felt this is the time where I had to take a decision to get into business. That's where in the MBA, from MBA first year, I became a trainer. And then after MBA, I didn't go for campus placement. Immediately, I came to Hyderabad. And then I started training few BBA students because MBA people were not getting. Though I was having enough practical experience, I went to ICBM, I went to Aurora Business School, I went to Dhruva College of Management, I went to Shiva Shivani, I went to ICFI Business School to become a faculty in supply chain management and marketing. But they said, you need enough experience, boss. At least 4 to 5 years experience, or you need a PhD to become a lecturer, because I was interested in teaching. So I thought part-time I'll teach and evening time I'll work on digital marketing. But that didn't work. Every college that I went had neglected me, or they said you are very short to teach people. I thought, okay, this is not working, so let me search BBA colleges. Then in and around Panjagutta, I started training BBA students on operations management and human resource management. And part-time, that is from 9 to 12. And from 12 to night, what I used to do is, I used to work on creating content for Hyderabad on digital marketing. Because anyways, I was already into online training. So I thought, why don't I start an institute to teach Hyderabad? So when I came in the year 2014 was the start. At that point of time, there was not even a single institute that teaches digital marketing. So when I came from Bangalore, I went to Amirpet, I did a big research, and I got to know that there are no institutes. This is a nice opportunity. Then what I did is, I started a company, company. Before it was different company, I renamed the company to Digital Nest. And then I started my operations with 6 students in 2014. Today, 200 to 300 people, 300 people are passing out every month from Digital Nest. But 4 or 5 years, 6 years ago, it was only 6 students per batch, 10 students per batch. We started with a very small quantity, and then we became famous, and then finally we got good recognition. And now we are having three branches. One is in Panjagutta, Hitech City, and Hitech City we have one more branch. So that's a growth story of mine. So there was no team, there is nothing, there is no money, but somehow the other way I worked hard, struggled hard, and finally reached this position. Today we have 43 trainers, 20 employees, total 63 is what you call employee count. And the turnover, if you see somewhere around, we were doing 30,000 6 years ago. Now we crossed somewhere around 30 lakhs in last 6 years. Now, why I'm introducing you so much this all details is there could be some aspiring entrepreneurs, and most of you people are MBA students. When I deliver a session to BB or some other students, I don't even talk this much. But I think this should help you to understand, like, if you wanted to grow as an entrepreneur or if you wanted to grow in your life, all that you have to do one thing in your life is, every day you have to keep learning. So learning is an ocean. It has got no end. Even yesterday, though I'm a digital marketer, I enrolled for a course called AWS, Amazon Web Services. Of course, it is not related to my subject, nor related to my life. But why am I learning? Because market is uncertain. We don't know what is going to happen tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So it's always better that you keep learning, keep working hard. Then only what will happen is we can reach our goal. Though you reach your goal, job is not just, it is a goal, that's it. Once you are in job, no guarantee that our job will be there forever. Until and unless you have hundreds of skills, people are not ready to retain you, or people are ready to give you more packages. So today I am an entrepreneur because I can create a graphic, I can shoot a video, I can edit a video, I can deliver a session, I can do counseling, I can do sales, I can do lead generation, I can do complete marketing, I can manage my website, I can create my website, I can edit my website, I can do everything. So if you are a jack of all trades, master of none, I think you will have a very good growth in the coming life. So this is all about me. But the colleges who ignored me in 2014 called me as guest lecturers in the year 2016. Means they told at least you need 4 years experience. In next 2 years, they realized that they again called me back actually. So fine. So this is all about me. I'm working as a consultant for Future Group and even Mera Events, Care Hospitals, and various startups as well. And I'm also guest lecturer at ICBM, ICFI Business School, Amity Business School, and Lovely Professional University as Jalandhar, and various business schools in and around Hyderabad and other cities. So this is all about me. And Distalness we have established in 2012, trained more than 7,000 plus students so far. We got a recognition that we are a Google Premier Partner company. So this partner badge is given only to few companies across every city in India. So we are one. And we are also awarded by Times of India's Education Icon of Hyderabad. And we are located in Hitech City and Panjagutta. Along with that, the learning fashion of people are changing. So we also started an e-learning portal where people can go and where they can pay money online and they can sit at home. At any flexible time, people can learn through our recorded videos. And all the doubt clarification, assignment material, everything is available in a portal called Digital Nesh Prime. So we are basically into classroom training, online training, and e-learning. So this is all about Digital Nest. Apart from digital marketing, we teach on Salesforce, we teach on Amazon Web Services, we teach robotic process automation, and then we also teach data science, machine learning, and Python. These are few of the courses that Digital Nest teaches today. Once upon a time, we were teaching only digital marketing. So today we are having a bunch of 8 courses that we are delivering to the entire Hyderabad and across the globe. So let's quickly now get into digital marketing. From here, the basic phase begins. Your basic phase got started here. So what is basic? This all you must be knowing, but if we don't teach this, then we cannot move further. So that's the reason I'm gonna cover this topic. So let us see actually what we were doing before and what we people are doing today. So before we were texting people or we were calling people with using these buttons. Today we are no more using these buttons. Always we are going to WhatsApp, Hike, Telegram, or any other applications. So the mode of communication got changed because of what internet, right? Next, before to book a cab, you have to go to Meru Cabs, Green Cabs, or Dot Cabs. They don't even know the address. You have to give a phone call to them. Today, Ola, Uber are directly coming to your doorstep just because of internet. So the mode of transport also got changed through what? Internet. Before, you had to call restaurants for food. Today, restaurants are directly coming to your doorstep. Swiggy, Fazer's, Food Panda, they are coming to your doorstep. All because of what? Internet. So the way you consume your food, the way you cook, everything got changed because of, again, through what? Internet. Before you were going to consultancies to book your travel plans. Today you are using ClearTrip, Yatra.com, MyTrip, and other portals. All this, again, your travel industry, the booking industry, all hotel industry, all this tourism got changed through what? Again, through internet. before to talk to someone, we were meeting in person. Today, most of the companies, if you see during lockdown, Zoom and GoToMeeting are trending apps actually. So Skype, GoToMeeting, Cisco, Zoom, all this has changed the way that the recruitment industry works, the training industry works, and the way the communication pattern from one person to other. Instead, people are using these applications, and this all is again through what? Through internet. Before you want to search a job, you have to go and search in newspaper. Today we are using Naukri, Monster, Indeed, LinkedIn. All these are again the recruitment industry got changed through what? Internet. Before, you were standing in a queue to buy tickets. Today we are using Book My Show, Explora, Mera Events to book any events or whatsoever. So all this again got changed through what? Internet. Before we used to stand in a retail outlet to recharge phone. Today we are using Paytm, FreeCharge or MobiQuick. So all these are again the way you recharge, all this industry also got changed to what? Internet. Now before you used to stand in a queue to withdraw money, then came what you call ATM, then you got mobile apps, then Paytm, then PhonePe, Google Pay, and now we have UPI payments. Your entire banking industry, financial transactions also got changed through what? Internet. Before you were going to market to buy groceries, today we are using bigbasket.com. So there's again an innovation when it comes to groceries or vegetables. We are procuring it online through this particular portals. Now the way you buy also got changed through what? Internet. Now before it was people were reading books. Now people don't have time to read the books. They're always using ebooks or YouTube videos or blogs. So your learning patterns also got changed through what? Internet. Before to search a house, you have to go to Two Light Boards. Today you can go to MagicBricks or 99acres.com. So the complete real estate industry also got changed through what? Internet. So before you had to go to retail outlets to buy. Today you can use Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, Paytm and others. Again, all you are buying, the way you buy products, the commerce, that is it. I mean, complete retail has gone into e-commerce. Again, because of whom? Because of internet. Before it was tape recorder, from tape recorder came CD player, from CD player came MP3 player. Now people don't even have time to download the songs. We are always watching on Hangama, Saavn or Wink. So the music industry also got changed through what? Internet. Before it was TV, from TV came YouTube. After TV we started watching YouTube. Now we want everything in the form of Netflix, Hotstar, Amazon Prime. So we all are glued to this particular OTT platforms. So complete media industry and movie industry, entertainment industry also got changed through what? Internet. What you have seen on the right side, the common thing that you have seen is internet. So what has internet done to you? Internet has done something called it has become a basic necessity for you. It is like an oxygen for you. If there is no internet for at least 2 hours, 3 hours, if there is no water for 6 hours, 7 hours, fine, or food if you don't have, fine. But if you don't have internet for an hour or two, we are not able to survive. That's how it has become a basic necessity. In short, if you call, it has become an addiction for all of us. We are not able to survive without what? Internet. So now what an advertiser or a marketing guy or a business owner, if they want to sell something to someone, first what they'll try to know is they'll try to know the weakness of the customer. If we know the weakness of the customer, then only what we can do is we can try to sell something. For example, if you take IPL, why do they promote IPL? Because the weakness is people love sports and people love sports stars or cricket stars. So they wanted to see on the screen, so they'll put their money and they'll watch this on the screens or on the ground. So that's the reason Lalit Modi has come with a concept called IPL to make money. So the weakness is what? Here people need entertainment. They are free on summer. They need something and you are bringing something. So here the weakness is what? Internet. So your entire globe is suffering from a weakness called internet. So when every advertiser, when they come to know that, oh, this fellow is suffering from a weakness called internet, I'll try to make money out of internet. And that's where a new concept came into picture called digital marketing, because the way you see TV got changed. You are not watching TV. You are always on Netflix or on YouTube or somewhere, or you are always on Instagram or Facebook. You want to read something. You're not using books. You are going to blogs and you are reading. So your entire, the way you buy buy things, everything got changed. So when your people are changed, obviously the marketing fashion should change, right? For people don't have time to read a paper today. People don't have time to watch TV today. People don't have time to look at any traditional pamphlets, leaflets. People throw it on the road if you distribute. People are not interested. When people are not interested, what they are interested is on internet. So internet may how to market. There is a topic called digital marketing. So what is digital marketing in short? So digital marketing is a combination of three elements. One is TV plus radio plus internet is called what? Digital marketing we call. A combination of three. One is TV plus radio plus internet. So a digital marketing is a guy who should be proficient with TV advertising, radio advertising and internet advertising. But in the market, what people are doing is they replace this internet marketing as digital marketing. Instead of using this TV and radio, they are now the new buzzword. What people have done is they are interpreting internet marketing as digital marketing. So let us go with the flow. How people are calling internet marketing as digital marketing. So let us also in this session we'll discuss about, actually we are discussing about complete internet marketing only, not digital marketing, but we'll use a word called digital marketing for now. And digital marketing is a new age marketing we people are going to discuss. So to market something, first you need a product. So what is meant by a product in digital industry? Product, according to a digital marketer, first, if I want to sell something, first I need traffic to the website. So if I need traffic to the website only, I can sell. So for me, website is the first product. If I want to sell a website or a mobile application are the products, because I have to pull people there first as a marketer. So if I want to pull there, what should I do? So first I should understand what types of businesses are available in the market. So one is called an offline business. Second is called an online business. Third is called mix, offline plus online. Fourth we call bloggers, people who earn money through blogs. So we are going to discuss about all the four business models in detail. So what is an offline business? Offline business is nothing but you can take, there are a few images that I put here. One, it can be a fitness center, it can be a bakery, it can be a saloon, or it can be a tuition center, or it can be a tutorial point, or it can be a coaching center or a college. Or you can take many other examples. It can be a hardware shop, or it can be a diagnostic center, or it can be a hospital, or it can be Big Bazaar, or you can take DMart. All these are offline businesses where payment is done on the ground. People go, they experience the service and they pay money, or they want a product, they'll go and they'll pay money on the ground. They are going to do this activity. They are called what? Offline business. Means typically what in your website, if there is no payment gateway, that is called an offline business. Now, what is important for offline business in digital marketing? Right, tomorrow you got a job in a particular, you got a job in Cult Fitness, or you got a job in, Gold's Gym in Himayat Nagar. They appointed you as a digital marketer, or you got a job in Natural Saloon, or you got a job in Country Oven. Now, what is your digital marketing activity? What is that they want from you? Let's discuss in detail. So let me take you through my site. Quickly, can you post in the chat box? Are you able to hear my voice? Is it clear? Can you type yes, yes, yes? Just a check. Right, perfect. Okay. So let me go to digitalnest.in. So this is our website. So it is digitalnest.in. Now I can consider, let me close all this. Right. This is our website. Now what we are looking at is Our institute is located in Panjagutta and Hitech City, right? We are an on-ground business. That means we are considered to be as what? We are considered to be as an offline business. So what do I need? For example, tomorrow, if you people are working for my company as a digital marketer, what is that I need first? First, I need people to come to my website. That means if people are not coming to my website, they will not click or they will not fill the query form or they will not call the phone number, right? First, I need traffic to the site. From where will you bring traffic? You have to do digital marketing. That way people are going to discuss in detail in the next slides. So you can bring traffic from Instagram, you can pull traffic from Facebook, you can pull traffic from Google Ads or emails or whatsoever it is, you can pull traffic. Now traffic is nothing but what? Visitors are coming to the website. After they come into the website, what is that what we need? Either they should call this phone number for admissions or to inquire about the courses, or we want them to go to which page? We want them to go to the contact us page, and they should fill the what you call query form on the website. If they are calling us or if they are filling this form, that indicates that we are generating a lead is nothing but it is called, if they are giving us a phone call or if they are filling the form, then our marketing team job is done. Next, whose job will begin? The sales team ka job will start, and they will gather the data and they'll start sending SMS mails and they'll give calls and they'll do numerous cold calls or whatsoever, and they'll try to convert you guys, right? But as a marketer, what is important when I work for offline business or I'm working for a Gold's Gym? If you are working for Gold's Gym as a digital marketer, what will you do? Either you should get phone calls for membership, to booking the memberships, or inquiry forms you should get. Or you are working for a saloon, either people should call for booking appointments or they can fill the query form. So all these on-ground businesses, we need phone calls or we need what? We need inquiry forms to be filled. And this is nothing but what we call this as lead generation. 85% of the jobs in digital marketing mostly are lead generators. If your people are very good lead generators, you can get 5x, 10x, 20x salaries. Generating leads is more important than doing marketing for us. We want people to come in. All that a business owner wants is we want phone calls and we want query forms. If you are filling, then it is my responsibility to convert them. As a marketer, your duty is to get me more number of calls and more number of form fill-ups is more important for us. So if you consider offline business, in offline business, we want leads. That is our secondary metric. But if a person has to come and fill this particular form, what is important? One second, let me close this browser. Right. If a person has to come and fill this form, first he should come to the website, right? He should visit the website. If he doesn't visit the website, then we cannot get leads. So your primary metric is what? Visits. So how does this happen? He should visit the site, call the phone number on the website, or fill the query form and then go to the thank you page. Thank you page will come only once he fills the form. So this is about offline business. Online, you already know. So online, you already know that. So for example, if I go to Amazon.in site, for next 5 minutes, it will be very basic and then we will get into the topic, right? So online, you already know. For example, if this particular book is there, so let me click on this. Okay, they had minimized this, or let me type any laptop or something. See, all these are currently unavailable because the central government has banned e-commerce companies from delivering products. But let us assume that you are working for Amazon e-commerce industry, or you are working for Make My Trip. Tomorrow you got a job in Make My Trip or Goibibo or Swiggy or Amazon or paisabazaar.com, bankbazaar.com or cardeco.com. This kind of sites you got a job. Now, what will be your job as a digital marketer is you need to pull traffic to the website, and then you will find a button. Then you will find a button called buy now button. You'll find a button called buy now button. So here we want people to come and click on the buy now button. That is a secondary metric. But if people have to click on the buy now button, first they should come to the site, right? So whether it is offline site or online site, first we need is what? We need visitors to the site. Second, what we need is sales. So first people should land on the website, then they should go to the payment gateway page, and then finally they should reach the thank you page. If they are reaching the thank you page, sale is done, or else we need visitors. So here also primary metric again, what we need is what? We need visitors. Next mode of business is mix. Mix is nothing but offline plus online. What is mix mode of business is offline plus online. If you look at my website right now, this is an offline business where people can click on contact us form and they can fill the details. We need leads. Apart from that, we have, for example, I have other website called digitalnishprime.com. So here what is important, people can go, they can click on the courses, they can select e-learning or online, and they can make the payment online. There will enroll now button, and then they will be routed to what? They'll be routed to the cart page. People can pay through cash, online, or direct bank transfer. So we consider now ourselves as what? Offline plus online, where a customer can make a decision online and make the payment, or he can come to the store, he can experience. Store is nothing but he can come to the institute and experience our service and then make the payment. So now what we are supposed to do, if you're working for such a company which has got payment gateway, where people have to buy online or people have to come and experience, or you can take any boutique. So in a boutique, there's a physical boutique. People can come and they can buy saris over there, or they can go online and they can buy. So here what is important, we need both. We need leads for offline and we need sales for online. And then again, if to have to for a person to come and click on this confirm order or whatsoever, again what you need traffic to the website, isn't it? Right, so this is called mix. Next type of business that we have is bloggers. What are these bloggers doing? So bloggers are nothing but they keep writing articles like what is cancer, how to cure cancers, what are the symptoms of cancer, what are the best cancer hospitals in Hyderabad, what are the best cancer hospitals in India, what are the treatments for cancer, what are the latest treatments for cancer. They keep writing articles. Why would they write for free? One day, 2 days, they can write for free. Ultimate goal is they want to put ads on the website. And if people click on these ads, they wanted to make some money out of it. So they can put Amazon ad, they can put Flipkart ad, or they can put Google ads. Google pays per click. Each click, 2 rupees, 20 rupees, 30 rupees they can earn. Or if they click on this particular ad, if the customer clicks on this ad and if he goes and if he buys the product, then Amazon can pay 10% commission or 5% commission. So all these are a part of what blogging practice actually. So, but if a person right now, for a blogger to make money through ads, he needs ad clicks and he also needs engagement on the site. So when will this happen? Only when the audience come to the site. So primary again you need is a visitor, right? Then secondary is our metrics like what? Ad clicks or engagement. So primary is again a visitor is required here. Now the common thing that you people have seen here in offline business also, you visitor is required. If it is online business also, you need visitor. Then if it is mixed business also, you need a visitor. Even if it is blog, even if you are running a blog or you are working on a blog and you want to make some money also, you need a visitor finally. So common indicator what we saw is a visitor. Now where are these visitors? Now how do I get these visitors is what we are going to discuss in detail. So what are we going to do to get visitors? There are some digital marketing practices we people are going to use to pull the primary metric called visitor to the site. So first metric is you need a website or a blog, then only the visitor would come there. Then you have to do search engine optimization. Then we have Google AdWords, display ads, search ads, video ads, social media marketing, email marketing, affiliate marketing, analytics, then lead generation and content marketing. These are some of the practices that if you people do, then you can get traffic to your website. If traffic is coming, then what will happen? Leads can be generated, sales can be generated, or anything can happen on the website. But first and foremost thing that every company needs is traffic to the website. So now let us get in detail. First, what is a website? A website can be of two types, one for an offline business and other for an online business. Offline business, you all people can create this website, which I created this website. I don't know coding, I hate coding, but I was able to design this website in 4 days. This entire website, I was the one who designed it without writing a single line of what? Code. So you all also can do it. All that you have to learn to create any site, you need to learn WordPress. So WordPress is a platform where easily you can customize your site and you can move all the options. You can drag and drop this photo, you can drag and drop. No coding is required. You'll get a lot of things you people can use WordPress. And you can put the query form. If you put query form, it becomes an offline business. Or if you connect a payment gateway can be any payment gateway vendor if you people connect, and then if you use buy now button or anything, then it becomes what? An online business. The only difference is in offline business you find query forms, in online business you find payment gateways. So what are the different on? If you want to create an e-commerce website, if you want to create, the options are available. Are one is you can go with Magento, so you people can create, or there is one tool called PrestaShop. So without coding, you can use Magento, PrestaShop, and you people can create nice e-commerce websites as well. So if you people are into any, right. So this is all about website. So now let us assume we have a website. We are having an e-commerce website, and we also have a blog. So let me open my blog as well. Right, so this is a blog where we keep writing articles. So you can see there's an article, social media image sizes guide in 2020. So we keep writing articles every day, and this is called a blog. The only difference between website and a blog is, in website we will be creating pages, these are called pages. In blog we'll be creating categories and posts. So this is one post. So how do bloggers make money? You can put ad number one here, right side you can put ads, or here you can put ads, or in between the content you can place ads and you can make some money. Now let it be a blog, let it be an e-commerce portal, or let it be an offline website. Ultimate goal is we need traffic. So how do we get traffic? We are going to discuss in detail. Now who are bloggers? Bloggers are people who write on health, fitness, technology, beauty. You can collect question papers and you can put classified sites, electronic gadgets, environment, news, movies, food, travel, exam results, education, coupon. You can take, if you people are interested in content marketing, daily 2 to 3 hours if you people can spend, and if you can write this kind of articles, nice articles if you can write, then what will happen is you can earn money through what? Through Google ads, or through Amazon ads, or Flipkart ads. You can get at least your current bill, or at least 2000 or 3000 per month pocket money at least you people can get if you are good with content. So this is all about blogging. So whether it is blogging, or whether it is an e-commerce portal, or whether it is an offline business, ultimate goal is we need traffic to the website. So how do we get the traffic? So now let's get into the actual topic of digital marketing. So we got to, first what we did is we realized that internet is important. Internet is a weakness, and we came to know that through internet you can do marketing. Next, how to do marketing? First, we need a website. So we divided a website into four types. One is online, offline, mix, and blogs. Now if it is online, offline, mix, or blog, find the ultimate goal is to pull traffic to the website. Now we are into a topic called how to pull traffic to the website, or we can call this as how to acquire visitors to the website. So to acquire visitors to the website, what I did is I have segregated digital marketing into two types. One is called free and second one is called paid. Free we call as organic. Anything, if you, for example, you are going to Facebook and you are posting something, are you paying money to Facebook? No, you are not paying money. If you are not paying money, boleto, that indicates it is organic. Okay, if you are paying money to run a sponsored ad in Facebook, that is called inorganic. So first what we guys will do is we'll discuss about organic. So organically how to pull traffic to the website. So first let's go with the technique number one. Technique number one is called search engine optimization. So what is meant by search engine optimization? Let's see. So this is our technique number one, SEO. So we are at this particular topic called search engine optimization. So now how does search engines work? So if someone types, let us take a keyword, data science training in Hyderabad. Let me type this keyword, data science training in Hyderabad. So when I typed data science training in Hyderabad, you can see there are what you call four ads on the top. This is ad number one, this is ad number two, this is ad number three, and this is ad number four. And let me go down at the bottom, there are three more ads. This is ad number 5, ad number 6, and ad number 7. Total how many ads do we see in the Google search is, first let us learn actually how Google search looks like, so then it will become easy for you to understand. Four ads on the top and three ads at the bottom. See, this is ad number 5, ad number 6, ad number 7. So overall you are having total what you call 7 ads, right? So four ads on the top and what you call three ads at the bottom. So total 7 ads you have. Then apart from that, what Google has got? Google has got three maps. You can see map number one, map number two, and map number three. So you have how many total? Three maps. After maps, what do we have right now? We have 10 SEO results actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, total 10 results will be there. So how many results do we have? 10 SEO results we have. Right. So now Google search consists of, first we let us learn actually who Google is. So Google has got 4 ads on the top, 3 ads at the bottom, total 7 ads. When we say ads, they are paid. So let us not discuss those right now. We are not going to discuss about this 4 ads because they are paid. It will come under paid topic. The next slide we are going to discuss about paid. We are not going to discuss about this 3 ads as well. These are paid. Now what are we going to discuss about this 3 maps? You can see there are 3 maps. So today we are, right now we are going to discuss only about this, what you call, 3 maps and 10 SEO results, but we are not going to discuss about ads. We'll be discussing this after 10 to 15 minutes of time. Right, what is 3 maps and 10 SEO results? Maps also, again, we'll spend after completing this bottom layer, then we'll go to the top layer. Now, you can see, right now I type data science training in Hyderabad. So there is someone called Kelly Techno and there are 2 to 3 institutes that are coming on the top in Google search. Now, what is search engine optimization is? Whatever the word that you people type here, whatever you type in Google search, from now on, it is called a keyword. So when you type a keyword, Google will show something in Google search. Let it be anything. You search for Apple, it will show Apple. If you search for digital marketing, it will show for digital marketing. If you search for Bhadruka College, it will show Bhadruka College ka, website. So whatever it is, Google is going to show the results. So now what you are typing here is called what? Keyword. Like in Swiggy, you might search for food, or in Amazon, you might search for a product. Whatever it is, if you are searching something, that is called a keyword. When you type something, you can see some results here, right? Total 10 results will be there. Now, what is search engine optimization is? For this particular keyword, if you have a website, if you are also a data science training institute, if you can take your website to top in Google search, and that is called what? Search engine optimization. So why that is a marketing technique, bolito? We people are lazy. What we people do, if we know that these are ads, or if we people are not interested in maps, directly we'll go to the first 4 or first 5 results only. And because we are lazy, we don't have time to go to second page, third page, fourth page. So most of the people, if they have any problem, whom will they go first? They'll go to Google and they'll ask. So if your website is on the top, what will happen? People will click on that and they'll land on your website. That means you are getting good traffic. After landing on the website, he might fill the form, he might click on the ad, or he might click on buy now button, he might buy the particular product or whatsoever. That is secondary metric. But we need traffic. If we need traffic, you have to go to top in Google search, and that is called search engine optimization in short. And this is a marketing technique. So, and this is free. You need not have to pay money. That is, Google is not going to charge you anything free of cost. If you use your brain, if you're paying money, it will be shown in the form of ad. So it's free, you people can use it. Now, if someone types, for example, best MBA colleges in Hyderabad. Okay, let's take one more keyword. So when I type best MBA colleges in Hyderabad, forget about this results, but let us discuss about SEO results. College Dunya is coming on the top, Siksha is coming on the top, MBA Universe is coming on the top, College Search is coming on the top, What After College is coming on top, WhatsApp Life is coming on the top, but there is no what you call college site. So for example, I am working for Bhadruka. Let us assume I am appointed as digital marketer for what you call Bhadruka College. So this is my website, let us assume. This is our site, so that you people can easily understand. Bolka, I'm taking this example. So this is our website, let us assume. Now tomorrow, if you people are appointed as a digital marketer for this particular college to do more number of admissions for MBA, or let us assume they started a B school somewhere in and around Hyderabad, and their intake is through, by paying 10 to 12 lakhs only, you can get an admission. So simply people will not come to 10 to 12 lakhs, right? For the first time, if your people are starting, if it is not reputed, it will take some time. They need a digital marketer for it. So let us assume they had appointed you as a digital marketer. So now what happens, if a person types best MBA colleges in Hyderabad, your duty, I mean, as a marketing guide duty, you have to take Bhadruka College website website to top in Google search. If your people are taking Bhadruka College to top in Google search, what will happen? People will, if they'll type in best MBA colleges in Hyderabad, best business schools in Hyderabad, or people might type MBA colleges, people might type PGDM colleges, people might type top rated colleges in Hyderabad, people might type list of MBA colleges in Hyderabad, people might type best business schools in Hyderabad, people might type B school in Hyderabad, people might type top rated B schools in Hyderabad, people might type anything. We don't know what a customer is going to type, what his query is, but anything relevant to your business, if he's typing, if you can take your website to top in Google search, is called what? Search engine optimization. So now he typed best MBA college in Hyderabad. Who is coming? College Dunia is coming. I typed MBA colleges in Hyderabad. Siksha is coming on the top. That means the position is changed now. When I used best MBA colleges in Hyderabad, we found College Dunia person, I typed MBA colleges in Hyderabad. You can see siksha.com is coming. And let me type top MBA colleges in Hyderabad. Again, Siksha is coming, and then College Dunia is there in the second version. Let me take another example, hotels in Hyderabad. Maybe Siksha is done very good. Let me type hotels in Hyderabad. When I type hotels in Hyderabad, Make My Trip is coming on the top, booking.com and Trivago is coming in the second, third position. Now, if I change even one word, if I use best hotels in Hyderabad, now what has happened? TripAdvisor is coming. Make My Trip is not coming on the top. So even if a person changes even a single word also, what happens? The entire results keep changing from time to time. And this is called, we don't know what people are searching. So let them type hotels in Hyderabad. Let them type budget hotels in Hyderabad. Let them type top hotels in Hyderabad. Let them type top rated hotels in Hyderabad. Let him type list of hotels in Hyderabad. Let him type only hotels or hotels in Amirpet. Let him type anything. But if the common word hotel he is typing, if you have a hotel website, you need to take that to the top in Google search. And that is called search engine optimization. So this is about what SEO, that is search engine optimization. Now let us get into the next topic called local SEO. Now what is the difference between SEO and local SEO? SEO and the local SEO is nothing but, this is called a global SEO, and here you people can see there are few maps here. These are called local SEO results. What is local results are nothing but, this is not connected to your website. This is connected to your website. If they click on this, they'll land on your website. If they click on this, they'll land on your map. So local businesses, what they do is they'll register Google Maps, right? So for example, if you people are working for same, let's take the same example called Gold's Gym. If someone types in Koti best fitness centers in Hyderabad, best gyms in Hyderabad, if they search, Gold's Gym map should come on the top. Of course, in and around Koti, there could be thousands of gyms or 500 gyms. But Google will give importance only to how many, only three listings. So if you have to optimize your map, if your map should go to top, if map is going to top, when a person is in that particular area, in and around that area, maps will be shown. But for example, if Dilshuk Nagar guy cannot see a map that is located in Koti, only in Dilshuk Nagar, if famous gyms are not there, if they're not doing optimization, then there could be a chance that the Gold's Gym might be reflected even in Dilshuk Nagar. So this is for local businesses. For example, you are located in Kondapur and you are typing best hospitals in Hyderabad. In and around Kondapur, the best hospitals Google is going to show. How does Google know they are best? Google will not enter into their hospital. The search engine optimization guy will make sure that if someone types best hospitals in Hyderabad, his map should go to top in Google. So that is called what? Local search engine optimization is what we call. That is called local SEO. Using Google My Business account, we'll be doing this. So for global SEO, what it is, a guy who is from Malaysia or Singapore, even if he types hotels in Hyderabad, Make My Trip or TripAdvisor only will come on the top. But a Malaysia guy will not see this Park Hyatt ITC Kohinoor ka hotel. He'll only see this results, but he will not see what local results, because he is not in the locality of Hyderabad. So that's the difference between local SEO and particular generic SEO. So from here, from maps also, people might click and they might come to this site. So we are done with even local SEO as well. Right. Now let us move into the next one, social media optimization. So what is meant by social media optimization or social media marketing? So the basic difference between social media optimization and social media marketing is, if you go and post on Facebook without paying money, that is called optimization. And if you people pay money to Facebook ads, we call, as marketers, we call marketing actually. Now let us discuss in detail about social media optimization. So we all use Facebook, we all use Instagram, we all are Snapchat users, we all use Twitter, LinkedIn, and we are always on social media for sure. at least 3 to 4 hours or minimum 4 hours we are there on social media browsing something or the other along with your daily job. Now, what is important in social, as a social media marketer, if a company appointed you, let us assume you are working for McDonald's or you are working for Yatra.com, MakeMyTrip.com or any company, let it be. If you are working as a social media marketing guy, what is your job to do? See, basically, you might be posting hundreds of posts on Instagram, you might be posting hundreds of posts on Facebook, but for whom are you posting? You are posting it for your friends. When you post for your friends, you are least bothered whether your photo is looking good or not, whether you are posting a rectangle shaped image or square shaped image, or whether your content is in Times New Roman, Arial, Pura. We don't see at all what type of content we are using. We don't see all these things. Directly, randomly, we keep posting, that's it. But this won't happen when you people are working for a company. So because you are not going to deal with your friend, you are going to deal with the customer. Now the major problem for a Facebook marketing guy or Twitter or LinkedIn marketing guy, major problem is what happens is the reach of these particular platforms are less because there is a lot of audience there. They have to show the best post to you. So what is important here is what type of font you use, whether you'll use Helvetica, whether you'll use Roboto, whether you'll use Rodonto, whether you use Times New Roman, or whether you'll use Arial font, what graphic are you going to use, at what time are you going to post, whether you're going to post a square shape image or rectangle shape image, or you're going to post a video, first 10 seconds content, what should be there, last 10 seconds content, end content, what should be there, whether it can sell, whether you can get traffic to the website, whether people can click on the link looking at the video or not, looking at the image, can we get traffic, or other at least people can like, comment or share, whether engagement will happen or not. All these are questions that are arising for a guy who is into marketing before he creating a post. So it's not that easy like what we post to friends we do. At least we spend one day time to create one post, because one post can give good at least 500 people traffic to the website is equal to investing 10,000 rupees on Facebook to run an ad. So one quality post will take at least 4 to 5 hours to think what I should post, when should I post, what content should I write. Then only what will happen is you can get very good traffic. If you randomly keep posting, what will happen? Your reach will go down if the quality of the posts are less. Now, the problem with Facebook is Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn, all these people are all Ramesh and Suresh. They use the same concept. So how do they work? So let us assume you have 1,000 friends on Facebook. Today morning, 500 friends woke up. Today morning, 500 friends, they woke up. And this friends, what they did 3 engagements. What do you mean by engagement? Engagement is nothing but they must have liked, commented or shared, or they created a new post. So as 500 are your friends, right? So how many posts should come on your wall? 1500 posts should come on your wall. Now, are you getting all the 1500 posts on your wall? No. If you people go and check your Facebook, only few of your friends' posts are coming every day, but not everyone's post. But if you go to the newsfeed, you'll find the post, but it is not coming on your newsfeed. Why is it not coming on your newsfeed? It's just because there is an issue. The issue is what, you know, Facebook has got algorithms. Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, they have algorithms. What that algorithm do is, it gives ranks. It gives ranks to profiles. It will give rank to posts and it give ranks to pages. There's a ranking system that you people don't know that you are having a rank. We all are having a rank by Facebook. We all are, our posts are having rank, and our entire posts are having rank. Give me 1 second, guys. Right. So our posts are having rank, and for each and every post, there is a rank. If your rank is good, then only it will show to more number of your friends. If your rank is bad, it will not show. How does Facebook define that rank? So there are a lot of metrics Facebook has got based on the content, how much times you update your Facebook, what you are going to do, how much engagement you people are getting. For example, if you open your Instagram status, daily you guys can observe. Now you can open after the class and you can see most of the time what you guys get is the posts that you people are seeing every day. Those people status updates only you keep getting, not like all the other status updates. Why only those people are coming? Because your engagement with those people is very good. Because Facebook wants to show you how 7 7,000 followers. Can you see all the 7,000 followers post at one go? You cannot. So Facebook has to give you a good post from the people whom you love the most. So it has got a what you call algorithm, which will define whether what post to show, whose post to show. It will not show everyone's post, everything is hidden. Fine, take it, they are your friends. If they don't see your post, there is no problem for us, right? But what about business? You are working for a company. Your page has got 15,000 followers or 20,000 likes or whatsoever. And you don't have then you don't have an option of reaching to larger audience boleto, the company owner will remove you from the job. Now what is important is you need to understand your audience. You need to use all the analytical tools that are required on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, understand the pulse of the people, and right time, right post with right content, take enough time, and if your people post, then the rank of that particular post could improve, and then you can reach to the larger audience. It's not that easy your post can get good reach. Apart from that, Facebook works on a rule called 350 posts per refresh cycle. How many posts will Facebook show? It will show only 350 posts per refresh cycle. That means if I open Facebook right now, new 350 posts only it will show. But there could be 1,000 posts, but it can show only 350 posts per refresh cycle. And out of this 350 posts also, Facebook works on a rule called 80 by 20 rule. So what do you mean by 80 by 20 rule is nothing but 80% will be general posts from profiles or friends. Only 20% comes from pages. So you can see 20% of, if you consider 300, somewhere around 60 to 70 posts only we people are having chance. Now reaching that particular audience pace is very difficult until and unless you are a very good content marketer. If you are not a good content marketer, if you cannot write proper content, your one-liner, your content, your graphic, your color on the image, your timing of the post, if everything is fine, then there is a chance that you can get very good traffic to the website or engagement on your post. So this is how Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, they all work. They are having a lot of algorithms. But in this webinar, we cannot teach complete social media marketing, but I'm just giving you the basic examples actually. Next, let us discuss Quora. Quora is also one of the beautiful site where you people can get very good traffic. Most of the people go and post their queries there. You can go and answer them. If you write the best answer and if you can give the link there, from there also you people can get traffic to this site. Next, you can create a YouTube channel and you can promote your videos. If you can optimize the videos to go to first position, then what will happen is there is chances that after looking the video in the bottom, if there is a link, people can click and they might come to your site, or you can at least get branding. Next, what we have is direct mails. What is meant by direct mail? Direct mail is nothing but the mails that we guys use. Gmail, Yahoo Mail, Hotmail, AOL, Outlook, all these are what direct mails. That means you cannot send more than 500 to 700 mails at one go. From your Gmail, you can, for example, you're working for Flipkart, you have 2 crore database. To 2 crore database, if you guys want to send, Can you send using your Gmail? No, if you send, it will block. It will say there's a suspicious activity and they'll block your Gmail account. So what you are supposed to do, basically, you have to make sure that you have to buy some email marketing tool to send to more than 500 people. But Gmail supports only 500 to 700 or Yahoo supports 700 to 800 mails per day. But from this, how to pull traffic free, right? We are not going to pay money to Gmail. We are not going to pay money to Yahoo or anything as such. So what you guys can do is basically go and write a nice subject line, write a nice from name and write a content. And then if people are interested, they might click and they might come to the website. At least out of 500, if 10 people, 20 people are coming also, free of cost, you are pulling traffic to the website. Now about email marketing, we are going to discuss in the next slide. But for now, this is called direct mail. Direct mail is nothing but your Gmail, say personal mailing. In that you cannot create any nice HTML template, you cannot create a nice template or anything. Just you can write one text and one image you can add and you can send, from there you can get traffic. So these are all what organic techniques. So these all are little basic. Now next one will be very advanced, that is paid traffic. So how to acquire traffic? One is organic. Through search engines, we discussed taking your website to top in Google search is called search engine optimization. Local SEO is nothing but you have to take maps to the top in Google. Then we discussed how Facebook algorithm works, and the same even Twitter, LinkedIn, all this works on the same fashion. Right. Now let us move into the next one, that is paid. So inorganic. So let us get into inorganic. Now, guys, now we are moving into paid traffic. You pay money, put your credit card, put your net banking account or debit card, then maza, they go. It's simple, like you can pull a lot of traffic to the website because you are paying money. Without paying money is a talented guy. that without investing money on Google or Facebook or whatsoever, if he's able to pull traffic, that's good. But a company would need both. For a startup to begin business, free is important. But if you want to grow big, then definitely you have to go for paid, because you have to reach to the larger audience. You have to scale up your business, right? So that's important, actually. Now, how do we do that? Now, let's get into paid. Social media is having paid channels. Google is also having paid. Email marketing is paid. Affiliate paid. A lot of paid activities are there. Now, let us discuss about all the paid activities. I'll add one more topic called influencer marketing. I missed this. Influencer marketing also. Right. Now, let us go one by one. So, Google Ads. People in the market call this tool as Google AdWords. Few people call this as pay-per-click. Few people call this as search engine optimizers. Search engine optimizers, pay-per-click, Google Ads, or we call Google AdWords. There are four jargons people use in the market for this kind of professionals who deal with Google Ads. And this Google Ads is split into different types. One, we have search ads. Then we have display ads. Then we have video ads. We also have shopping ads for e-commerce and Gmail ads also. Right. Today in the class, we are going to discuss about three types of ads. And this Google Ads, people who learn this Google Ads, or if they are certified, but Google has got various certifications also. We'll be discussing about that also in the coming slides. If you people are certified and if you are learning Google Ads, there's a chance that you people can get jobs in Accenture, Cognizant, Genpact, HCL, TCS, Facebook, and Google. These are the multinational companies that are hiring whom Google Ads specialist. Apart from that, you can work for startups. If you people are learning SEO and all social media and everything, you can work for startup. But specifically, if you want a job in Google Ads specialist, if you want to become, then MNCs are the people they are going to hire. Apart from MNCs, there are some consultancies also who will be acting as third party vendors, like Regalix, Waterleaf's consultancy, and there is one more company called Global Logic. Even these people also will hire you and they'll make you to work in Google office, but the payroll will be on this particular companies. So this is about Google Ads. Now let us get in detail about each and every ad in detail. So first we'll go with what? Search ads. So search ads, first one, what is mean by Google search ads? Let's see. So I typed data science training in Hyderabad, isn't it? Now who is coming? There are something that you guys can see in the search. In the search of Google, if you people are running an ad, that is called what? They are called search ads. Okay. Now, how does this work? Now, this works on a concept called CPC. CPC, or we can call PPC, cost per click, or we can say pay per click. And what is mean by cost per click? What is mean by pay per click? See, if a person, what I will do is, I'll go to Google and I told to Google, Google, this is the keyword, data science training in Hyderabad, show my ad in the first position. And let me use annotations. And I told to Google that I will pay 70 rupees per click. PPC is how much? 70 rupees is what I told to Google. Now, the other guy, what he told is, he's ready to pay 60 rupees per click. 60 rupees per click. Now the next guy, what he told us, is ready to pay 50 rupees per click to Google. So Google is making money through ads. You can see how Google is charging money, right? So this guy says 50 rupees per click. Now who is paying more money? The first guy is paying 70 rupees per click, second guy is paying 60, and 50 rupees is paying. So now this guy told to Google for this particular keyword. Google Ads is a very simple tool, yeah. Even 10th class student or 15 or any degree student or anyone can learn this. But the problem is, I'll tell you in the coming classes where what talent is required. In next 5 minutes, I'll be telling you. Now, you can go to Google, you can open Google Ads tool, a nice title you can write, nice URL you can write, nice content you people can write, and tell to Google, I am ready to pay 70 rupees per click. Now what Google does is, if you win the bid for this particular keyword, who is winning the bid? Now this Facebook blueprint won the bid. Then what will happen? Its ad will be shown on the first position. Now 70 rupees per pay per click is nothing but if a customer clicks on this particular ad, I should pay 70 rupees per click. If 10 clicks I'm getting, 70 into 10 is how much? 700 rupees I should pay to Google. If I'm getting 20 clicks, then 1400 rupees I should pay only for which keyword? Data science. Again, the best data science training in Hyderabad, again, the bid cost might be 20 rupees, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 150 rupees. We don't know. Now, the beauty of this is Google is it's all secret bidding. This guy will not know how much this guy is paying. This guy will not know how much he is paying. It's all your talent. With your talent, you need to do bidding. Then you will be on the top in the Google search. Now, the problem here is at any point of time, let us assume this guy changed the bid from 60 rupees to, let us assume he changed to 75 rupees. Now, what will happen? Now his website will go to the first position and then this guy's website will come to the second position because he's paying more money per click, he's paying less money per click. And this is called real-time bidding, guys. Real-time bidding is nothing but basically at any point of time, no monthly system, no yearly system. Now the time is what? Now the time is 12:15. 12:15, now the customer, what he can do is 12:15, if he changes the bid price, it can go up. And 12:16, again, this guy changed to 78 rupees, then again, he might go to the top and again, this guy might come on the bottom position. So this is real time. Every second, the bids keep changing. When the people are changing, then everything will start changing actually. But the problem here is, who pays more money will be on the top is what I said, right? Now, this fashion is changed actually. This is 2012 May. Google used to consider people who pays more money. Now, what Google is considering? Though this guy pays 50 rupees per click. The first guy is paying how much? 50 rupees per click. Okay. And then the second guy is paying 60 rupees per click. Now, third guy is paying, let us assume, 70 rupees per click. Normally, what should happen by default 70 here? If you consider this, who should go to the first position? This guy should go to the first position, right? No, he will not go. What happens is Google is not only considering the price, Google is considering price into quality. That is cost into quality is what Google is considering. So cost into quality. So how this concept work is, let us assume GHMC has called called for a tender for laying a road. So three contractors came. One contractor is having lot of money but he doesn't have experience. Second guy is having average money and he's having good experience. Third guy is having experience but he doesn't have money. So good GHMC has to make money. Along with that, it wants to provide the good quality road as well. So it will go with whom? With the second guy. That is cost into quality. Similar way, Google also works on the same funda. Who pays good money into their quality, they can be on the good position. That means though this guy pays 50 rupees, if his quality is good, he can be in the first position. Though the other guy pays 60, though he's paying more money, if his quality is bad, then he'll be in the second position. So this is how the concept of what quality into cost. Now you people might ask, what is quality? I cannot explain everything because quality to explain takes 4 hours. But I'll give you a basic example. How does Google check the quality is? Might be the speed of your site. At what speed your website is loading. If your loading speed is fast, then the that is one factor. If your content in the site is good, then there is one factor. Like this, Google has got 15 to 20 factors which could define the quality of the ranking. So this is how Google search ads work. So from here also people are lazy, right? They click on the first ads and then what happened? You can get traffic to the website. So we are done even with what search ads also. So let me clear all the drawings, right? Right, so this is about what search ads. It works on a concept called what pay per click or cost per click, and quality matters here. Next, let us get into, now the story of Google is done here. From 4 ads we thought, from maps how to pull traffic we thought, from SEO results how to pull traffic also we covered. Now let us get into display ads. So what are display ads? So let me take you to a slide. So this is display ad. So in the if you want to get more traffic apart from Google, if you want, still what there are options. See, for example, I took a screenshot of this website called TechCrunch. In this, there are two banner ads. So for us to keep it very familiar with our subject, we'll assume that this is ICSL Lombard ad and this Tata Fortanka ad. Okay. Now, what is important for us is I want to get traffic from these ads to my website. How do I get traffic by putting display ads on other websites? Is we can go with two bits. One bit is called CPC, second bit is called CPM. CPC stands for cost per click. Means what I'll tell to Google, let us assume that this is ICSL Lombard site. ICSL Lombard guy went and told to Google, show my ad in TechCrunch site. I'll pay 2 rupees per click. His PPC is how much? Cost per click is how much? 2 rupees. Now, if he won the bid, if his quality is good, then what will happen? His ad will be shown. This ad will be shown to the, what you call, to the customer. Now, I clicked on this ad, 2 rupees ICSL Lombard has been charged. Then you guys clicked 2 rupees. I saw if 100 people are clicking, then 100 into 2 is almost 200 rupees Google will charge. So that's how cost per click works. But Google has got one more metric called cost per 1000 impressions. So what do you mean by cost per 1000 impression is like hoardings. So for example, we are there at Khairatabad. There are a lot of flyover, let us assume there are hoardings. Now on the hoardings, let us consider Maha Cement ad is there, Axe advertisement ad is there, and let us consider one more ad of Audi advertisement ad is there, Audi car ad is there. So you have Audi, Maha Cement and Axe. Now what is the expectation of an advertiser or a marketing guy there? If I put a hoarding, looking at the hoarding right now, you are on the bike, you saw Axe advertisement. Looking at the advertisement, will you directly rush to the retail outlet and buy the product? No, right? We will not rush immediately. Looking at the Maha Cement advertisement, will you directly go and buy a cement bag? No, right? You don't. But when will you buy? Tomorrow, when there is a requirement that you want a deodorant, when you go to a grocery outlet or when you go to a shopping, to a particular retail outlet, there while picking up the deodorant, your first choice could be Axe, because that fellow every day, whenever you are going here and there in TV, you are seeing Axe ad, you are seeing on hoarding Axe ad, on radio, you are seeing Axe, everywhere there is an Axe. So there is a chance that you will pick Axe. So that indicates that they are trying to brand. And later sale is important for them. Immediate sale is not important for them. Branding is important. Or for example, tomorrow you are planning to construct a house. You will not go for Bharati Cement, or you might go with Maha Cement, because you saw that ad every day. There's a chance that let me explore. So that is called branding. So there what is important? People looking at the hoarding is important. Means eyeballs or impressions are important there. People taking action on the hoarding, people are not, we cannot measure also. But Google also has got the same concept, same funda. Google has come with cost per 1000 impressions. What is cost per 1000 impression is? Now this ICSL Lombard guy, what he told to Google is, I'll pay 10 rupees for 1000 impressions, show my ad. So what you mean by 10 rupees for 1000 impressions is, if someone sees my ad also, I'm ready to pay. So how does this concept work? So for example, I am there. I open TechCrunch website. After opening TechCrunch website, now ICSL Lombard ad got loaded. That means whether I click on this ad or not, that indicates I saw this ad. If I saw that ad, one impression it was lost. Then you guys, second guy came and opened this site. He also saw second impression gone. Now another 998 people, if they come and if they load the site, even if they don't click also, even if they load the website, that indicates they saw the ad. If they see the ad, then Google will charge how much? 10 rupees. It can be 10, it can be 2, it can be 5 rupees. I'm just giving a rough estimate. No one is an expert. Until and unless you people, it's like a rummy game. As you keep playing, you will only come to know. So no, there is no Google AdWords expert. I might be an expert in the tool, but not for every industry. So as you keep exploring, then only you will come to know what bid price you people can invest. Right. So now what is impression is? Nothing but for branding. Big companies, what they do is, small companies, what do they need? At least people should click on this ad. Let them click on the ad and at least they should come to the website. Big companies, what they do, at least I need branding. Even if people don't buy the product immediately, every day I want to show them the ads. They will go with CPM, and small companies will go with what? CPC, that is cost per click. Now, how do you show these ads? You can show the ads based on age. For example, you want to promote Bhadruka College to MBA admissions. You can target people who are 20 years or 21 years or 22 years of age. People only in Google can see the ad. So we can target by age. We can target by gender. For example, you are working for Nykaa. There's a beauty products or MAC products for female product. I can run ads only to female. Female people. No one else in this world can see. Now you guys can question me, how does Google know my gender? Because when you people are signing up with Google, Google, what it is doing is, It is asking you what's your gender. So if your people are signed into Chrome browser with your Gmail ID, then only your ads will be shown to the female people, or else some other ads she might be seeing. Right, so that's how gender works. Next, you people can target based on location also. So what is location targeting? Means, let us assume you people are working for ENT clinic, or let us assume you are working for some dental clinic, a newly launched dental clinic, which is launched in Kompally. So they appointed you as a digital marketer. So if you want to work for dental clinic in Kompally, if you run ads to enter Hyderabad, will a Dilshuknagar guy go to Kompally for treatment? Or will a Medipatnam guy go to Kompally for treatment? He won't go, right? So what you guys can do is, you can target only to Suchitra, only to Kompally, only to Boinpally, or only to within Mitchell surroundings. Only those people can see the ads in Google. No one else can see the ads. So you can target by location. Now what has happened? You've made more money. And then what has happened? You started expanding to Dilshuknagar. Right now you move to Dilshuknagar. One more branch you had opened, Dilshuknagar. Now what you can do, you can run ads only to LB Nagar, only to Dilshuknagar, or in and around Ambarpet, Ramantapur. Only these people, Nagol people, can see your ads. Now you started one more branch in Jubilee Hills. Now what you can do, you can run ads to Panjagutta or this. Google has got a good nice options called, you can enter pin codes. Through pin codes, whatever the in that particular area or in that particular radius, people 2 kilometers, 3 kilometer radius, people only can see your ads. No one else can see, because you are wasting money showing to others, because it's of no use. They'll not come to you, right? So now Jubilee Hills, now you can target. Now you had expanded to Gachibowli, let us assume, and then you also expanded to even to Medipatnam, let us assume. So Medipatnam, and then you covered even KPHB. That means in and around Hyderabad, everywhere you have opened your clinics, let us assume. Now what you guys will do, instead of targeting location wise, you can target the entire Hyderabad, because entire Hyderabad, from that anyone can go anywhere and get the treatment done, because they are having a lot of branches. So like this. Or tomorrow you have expanded to Bangalore, you can target only Bangalore based on city, complete Bangalore you can target, or in Bangalore a specific BTM layout, Boleto, only in BTM layout they can see your ads. I say you can target by locations. That's one beauty option of what Google, where you people can target by what locations. Next, what we have is, you can target even by what you call devices. What is targeting by device? For example, you people are working for Apple company and you want to promote a Apple 12 phone. So if you want to promote an Apple 12 phone, you can target people who are using iPhone 10R only. Only iPhone 10R people can see the ad, no one else. Or Samsung has released a new phone, only Samsung people can see the ad, but no one else can see the ad. So you can even target by device. Only desktops people should see my ad. Only mobile people should see my ad. In mobile, I want to only Vivo people to see my ad. As you can target by devices also. Next, you can target by content. So how to target by content? Let's see. For example, you are working for Hyundai Verna. Okay, and your competitor is Honda City or Skoda Rapid. Okay, or let's take Volkswagen Vento. So this all, or let's take any other, let it be any car for that matter. So now all these are competitors to whom Honda City, Skoda Rapid, and these people are competitors to whom, to Hyundai Verna. Hyundai Verna is our company. We want to promote this sedan class ka car. So I want to sell this car. If I want to sell this car, I need to advertise. How can I advertise? I can target by content. What is targeting by content? You know, like, let me go to one of my blog. So let us assume this cardeco.com or zigwheel.com. I don't have time to now open and show guys, because we are running already late by 15 minutes. Let us assume this is cardeco.com, and here what you call Honda City Review, because it's our competitor, right? Honda City Review bolke, that fellow wrote an article. In this is mentioning the mileage of Honda City, Honda City reviews, what's new in Honda City, its seat covers, its headlights, all this. That guy wrote a what you call article. Now what I can do is, I'm working for Hyundai Verna, right? What I can do is, I can go and I can target wherever the word Honda City is there, in any articles, anywhere in the blogs in Hyderabad, wherever people are browsing. If they are browsing any Honda City articles, on the right side, on the top I can show Hyundai Verna, here I can show Hyundai Verna, in between I can show Hyundai Verna, on the right side also I can show Hyundai Verna. Because what I'm trying to do, a guy who is planning to buy Honda City car, he is doing research, for him what I'll show, I'll start showing Hyundai Verna. So I can even cross promote based on the content. So, or else, for example, if Bhadruka started a business school and if they want to sell admissions, wherever the word business school, MBA, MBA college, these words, wherever is written, there you can show what Bhadruka ka ads. And that's how you can pull even traffic to the website as well. So this is called targeting by content. Next one, what we have, targeting by interest. What is an interest targeting? You know, let us assume you people are planning to buy a house or an apartment. So your dad is planning to buy an apartment. So what your dad is doing every day, he's going and he's searching in Google. He's searching in Google apartments in Hyderabad, or you are helping your dad in searching apartments in Hyderabad. All this, you are doing a nice research on a lot of websites. But Google can collect your entire data, guys. Google can collect what you people are searching, all your interest, what is your recent interest, large interest, everything, your interest data will be there with Google. Now what I can do, if I'm working for Aparna Constructions, or if I'm working for My Home, or if I'm working for SMR Holdings, so what I can do is, I can target based on interest. So wherever you go to, for example, you go to, once again, let us assume you came and you are reading social media images size guide. Here also the ads will follow. Whose ads will follow? Aparna Construction's ads will keep on following, because your interest is what? Your interest, because your mind says you have to buy apartment, that I know already. So even if your people are going and reading movie reviews also, there also what will happen? Aparna ads will keep on following you, because we know that your people are searching for apartment. So like this, we people can target for what? On based on interest, content, devices, location, gender, age. So these are some of the options to what target, and then you can pull traffic to the website. So the bid type is what? CPC and CPM, cost per click and cost per thousand impressions. Now we are done even with what? Display ads. So now we are left with next one. This works on a concept called what? CPC, or we can call this a CPM, cost per thousand impressions. Now let us get into the next topic, video marketing. So Google Ads video. So how does video marketing works? Let's see. Right. Video marketing consists of three different types of ads. One is called an in-stream ad. Second one is called in-display ad. Third is called in-search ad. So what is in-stream, in-display, in-search? Let's see. The bit type that we use for video ads is CPV. CPV stands for cost per view. Means if the person saw that ad, that means Google will charge 2 rupees, 1 rupee, or whatsoever it is. So here the bid type is CPV. Now we have what? The in-stream ad. That's the first one. So you can see on the screen, there is a button called there's a button here, skip ad. This is a button that you people can see, that is skip ad. So after 5 seconds, when the advertisement gets started, you get what? Skip ad. Skip ad is what button you people get. In case if you people clicked on skip ad, then Google will not charge any money. But if the customer is audience, if I do not click and if I watch the ad for at least 15 seconds, then what happens? Google will charge 2 rupees or 3 rupees from this Grammarly or any advertiser. Now, how do I put this in stream ads? Means I can put in stream ads again based on content. I can target a particular videos. I can target a particular age group, gender, all this I can target, and I can see. If I want to show ads only male people on YouTube can see my female people. So wherever they go and they browse any short movies, or they browse any movies, or here and there in between, I can show my ads. Or I can target based on interest, content, location. All these are same. What we have discussed in display, the same will remain even for video ads as well. Okay. Now what is in stream? Already there is a movie that someone has uploaded to earn some money. In that particular movie, we can go and put our ads, and that is called in-stream ad. Based on the in the video, we are streaming our ad, and that is called in-stream ad. So this is one in-stream ad. Second one, what we have, next one, in-display ad. What is mean by in-display? In-display is nothing but this ads that you people can see are called in-display ads, that the ads that you see on the videos. Next one, what we call is in-search ad. In-search ads are nothing but the ads that are coming from it. Even a person types something in YouTube search also, you can show ads. And these are called what? In-search ads. Means if a person is searching for Samsung TV, I can show Panasonic ad. So I can do cross-sale, cross ads also I can do, because I'm having an option to do. I can do that. So this all comes under what? In search, in display, in stream. All this comes under what? Video marketing. And the bid type is cost per view. So we are done with video ads also. Right. Now let me even mark this in green color. That indicates we are done. with it. And the bid type for this particular ad, what we are using is CPV, that is cost per view. Right, so these are some of the ads in Google Ads. Apart from this, Google has got shopping ads also. Let me type shoes. Maybe right now they are running ads or not, I don't know. Yeah, you can see here, Nike, Kous, Fartech, you can see sponsored here. These are for e-commerce companies. What you can do is you can run Google shopping ads. This also comes under cost per click. Okay, and Google has got Gmail ads and many other ads are there here. I can, as it's a webinar session, I cannot go much in detail because we are having very limited time and I should give you maximum knowledge. So what are the best I can, I'm able to do. Right, next, social media marketing. Now let us get into social media marketing. The basic difference between Google and social media is what, you know, social media, your people are giving you all your personal details. Google doesn't know your personal details. It only knows what you're browsing, what is your age, gender, only that. But Facebook knows everything about you, in and out about you, right? So now let us discuss how Facebook works, how Facebook ads work. So for example, if I want to target an ad to a guy who is in Mysore, who hails from Hyderabad and whose age is 22 years, and who works for Infosys, whose designation is senior software engineer, and who did his BE in mechanical engineering from CBIT college, 2014 pass out, who speaks languages Telugu and Kannada, and who uses a phone called Vivo phone, and who is connected to 4G internet, Vivo some 741 model, let us write 741 model, right? Only this guy can see the ad here. I hope you people can understand. He should be right now in Mysore, but his native should be Hyderabad. His age should be 22 years. He should work for Infosys. He should be, his designation should be senior software engineer. He should do his BE mechanical from CBIT. He should be a 2014 pass out. He should speak languages Telugu and Kannada, and he should use Vivo phone. By mistake, he is in Mysore, Hyderabad, age, everything is done. But if he uses a Samsung phone, ad will not be shown. Now he should be connected to 4G internet. If he connected to Wi-Fi, ad will not be shown. So like this, precisely I can reach to a person based on age, gender. I can go based on the company name, designation. There are a lot of things that you people can use and target audience on where? On internet, on Facebook. Now I'll give one more example. Let us remove this example. Let us assume there's a Jain festival happening. Jain festival. So who will be participating in Jain festival? Only Jains will be participating because that's their festival. Now if you want to collect money from them for the event, what you guys can do is you can target even by the names. I show ad only to the first name or last name contains Jain bole to. Only those people wherever the word Jain is written, those names only can see the ad in Hyderabad. Others cannot see. Or you want to target complete country. In the country, whoever has written Jain in the first name or last name, if Jain is there, only Jain people can see the ads. Or you want to target to Reddys, you can target to Reddys. You want to target to Rouse, Chowdhury's, Bolito, Chowdhury's, if the first name, last name. Or you want to target only to by the name Shweta Bolito, only Shweta people can see the ad in Hyderabad. No one else can see the ad. So you can even target by first name, last name, zip code, pin code. All these options are available for you to target. Location, like how Google is having, more than Google, Facebook has got some 50 to 60 options where you people can target. Next, if you are working for a Malayali movie is released, they appointed you as a digital marketer. How you people can target on Facebook? You can target based on what? Language. If they're talking, because whenever we people create a Facebook, we'll say my age, my gender, my college name, my dad, this and all. Along with that, I'll also be mentioning what? I can speak Malayali. That means that I'm mostly, there's a chance that I'm a Malayali. So only Malayali people can see those ads of that particular movie. No one else can see. So that you are reaching to the precise targeted audience. So this comes under what? Facebook ads. Similarly, Twitter ads, LinkedIn ads. Now let us take one example about LinkedIn ads. Twitter ads are more or less like Facebook ads. Let's take LinkedIn ads, how you people can use. For example, you are working as a HR for Uber. Uber has hired you as a HR. Now they told, Uber people told, you need customer support and seller support people. customer support people you need for hiring. They gave you a target to hire 1,000 people. How will you hire? From where will you hire? So what you can do is, you can use a trick. What you can do is, you can go to LinkedIn. You can go to LinkedIn and run a sponsored ad. The sponsored ads will be shown only to Amazon people, and whose designation is what? Customer support. That means a HR can use Facebook or LinkedIn ads to reach what you call hirees. From there, she can hire the people. How she can do? She can run an ad on LinkedIn, or she can run an ad on Facebook. How she can run ad? She can target by company name. People who are working for Amazon in LinkedIn, they must have mentioned, I'm working in Amazon. Along with that, the designation they must have mentioned. So what this HR is trying to do, the Uber HR is trying to loot people who are working as customer support, because they are also in customer support. Even we are in customer support. So she's trying to loot these people to what? To Uber. So that's a marketing practice. Or let us take one more example, that you people are working as digital marketers for let us assume Haldiram company. So Haldiram, what it did is, during Diwali, it wants to sell sweets to corporates. How does it reach to corporates? Now what you people can do is, you can go to LinkedIn, you can run an ad connecting all the HRs who are working for Deloitte, Dell, Amazon, Google. So what you people can do, you can target by designation. Only people who HRs of Deloitte, Dell, Amazon can see your ads. No one else can see. And you will be running a nice ad. You can run, make your employees happy with our gifts, special offer for corporates, as a nice content if you people can run, and show ads only to HR people who are working here. So HRs might take a decision and they may procure the sweets, and Haldiram is going to be benefited from where? From LinkedIn ads. So all the B2B marketing can be done through what? LinkedIn. You are working for a web designing company, web development company, real estate company, whatsoever you want to do, any B2B connections, you can do it through what? LinkedIn. So this is some this is about what? LinkedIn. Now Instagram and Facebook are both one and the same. They work on the same, and Pinterest also has got ads. Now let us discuss Quora ads. In Quora also, you can promote your content in the form of an ad. People might click on that relevant topic and they might come to your site. Next, we have influencer marketing. What is influencer marketing? Is this is trending now. For example, if I pay 10,000 to Facebook, my ad might be shown only to 1 lakh people. But let us assume there is a model. I know there are many models, or there might be few people who are influencers, who are some coaches, or people who are actresses, or who are celebrities. What I can do, they'll have 10 lakh or 20 lakh followers on Instagram or on Facebook or on YouTube. What I can do for them, 10,000 is important. So what I'll say, I'll go and I'll pay them 10,000, and I'll ask them to create a post for my company, and you post on your Instagram or you post on your social media. They'll charge 10,000 rupees, and if I give them 10,000, if I post. Now Facebook, if I give 10,000, it can reach only to 1 lakh. But if this fellow post for 10,000, it can go to 3 to 4 lakhs, because he is having followers who are engaging with him every day. So influencer marketing came into picture recently after emergence of Instagram and YouTube and others. Most of the people are using influencer marketing as well. Now if you can find the right influencers in social media, your brand reach can go to, what you call, 4 to 5 times greater than what you promote on LinkedIn or Google ads or Facebook ads. It can give more reach and more engagement also, because people trust that guy influencer, because he is an influencer. People don't trust a sponsor ad immediately, but they can trust him because whatever he says is final, because they are his followers. He is like Yogi. Whatever he says is final. Aisa. So this all comes under influencer marketing. Next, let us discuss about email marketing, and then we'll come back into affiliate marketing. Right. So what's the time? 12:44. Okay. Fine. So guys, the time of extension is, we need 15 more minutes. So if you people can be patient enough, so I think I can extend by 10-15 minutes, and then we can be done with this session. Still, there are 4 to 5 topics to be discussed. Right. Now let us get into email marketing. So what is email marketing? Let me take you through a slide. Right. So email marketing, we all see this kind of templates in our email whenever we open. From many businesses, you keep getting a lot of promotional emails. Now, what is the difference between a direct mail and email? Direct mail, you can send only 500 mails at one go. You cannot send 5 crore mails. But if you buy MailChimp, Aweber, benchmark tool. Like this, there are some tools in the market. If you buy those tools, you can send lakhs of mails at one go. And with that, what will happen? You can create nice this kind of templates. You can create nice templates. You can write nice subject lines, from names, and you can design beautiful templates. And we can send emails to the customers. Now, how do we do this? Now, simple. We people are writing daily. How we people send mails? The same way you have to send mails. But here you are dealing with the customer, so you should be very conscious, and cautious before sending an email. What matters in email marketing, first and foremost thing that matters in email marketing, is first that email should go to inbox. It should not go to spam folder, or it should not go to promotion folder. That's the first problem. Second problem is what timing matters. At what time you send a mail matters, because when it comes to promotion mails, people ignore that very fast. So until and unless it reaches according to the time that they wanted, they will not open. So you should know actually what time to post. Third, what is important, people, when they open the mail, first what they see your from name. And then they see your subject line. If your from name and subject line is good, then they'll open the template. If your template is really good, then only they'll click on the buy now button or enroll now button or whatsoever. Then only you can get traffic. So it's not that easy. First, your from name matters. Your subject line matters. Then what matters? The timing of your mail matters. Then it should go to inbox. After all this hangama, then he should open the mail. Then he or she, if they love the content, then they might click and they might come to your site. Now there are, for example, if I send an email with from name Sandeep. Sandeep from name say, learn digital marketing in 50 days, I send to 10,000 people. Only 1,000 people opened. When I send with their name called Shweta, learn digital marketing in 50 days, out of 10,000 people, 2,000 people. That means she's getting very good opens. I'm not getting good open rate. Then what I will do from tomorrow, I'll remove from name called Sandeep and I'll continue with Shweta. So you have to experiment with from names. Few people might love female names, few people might love brand names, few people might love gender. Then you have to experiment with subject lines. We don't know what subject line people will love. You need to experiment. People might love red color, few people might love green color. This all comes under digital marketing. It is called A by B testing, multivariant testing. So there are many topics actually. That is all our advanced topics for now. This color, content, font, from name is important to get traffic to the website. So we are done with even email marketing also. From here also you can pull traffic to the website. So email marketing over. Influencer marketing also I gave you an idea. Next is affiliate marketing. So what is mean by an affiliate marketing basically is Google, Facebook, Instagram, email, you can convert any human being into a marketer. So there are right now, how many people are attending this session? There are 62 people who are attending this particular session. You all 62 people, what I can do is I can convert you people into marketers for my company. Now, how do I do that? So one thing, what I can do is I can release a coupon. Like I'll show you one example. So, right. So like Coupon Dunia, Cash Karo, Coupon Nation, what I can do from Digital Nest is I can create a coupon for you. That coupon code is only meant for you. No one else can see that coupon. So what you guys can do is you take that coupon, send it on WhatsApp or send an email or put on your website, do whatsoever it is. If someone uses the coupon and if they come to my website, if they come to the site and if they enter the coupon here, and if they enter the coupon here and if they click on apply, then the customer would get discount and you will get what? Commission. So I'm paying you commission for each coupon. So I can give you coupons. You people go and promote to your friends. If they come and buy my courses, I can pay you commission. Now what I'm trying to do is, instead of using Google, instead of using Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, I can also use you as a human being. Also can convert into marketer by what? By giving a small coupon code, because you are getting commission. Else I can also give you a link. I can give you a coupon code, or I can give you even a link. This link is only meant for you. I'll create 62 links. Each and every one, I'll send an email or SMS to you guys. Promote that link on Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, anywhere you keep promoting that link. If someone clicks on that link and if they come to my website, I'll pay you 2 rupees per click. If someone fills the form, I'll pay you 20 rupees. If someone buys my course, I'll pay you what? 10% commission. So what will happen? You will take that link and you'll keep on promoting wherever you want, because you are getting 2,000, 3,000 commission. For that, what you guys will do? You'll take that link and you'll keep on promoting wherever required. So you are going to get commission. Ultimately, what I am getting, I am paying you small set of commission, but I am getting traffic to my website. I am getting business also. So converting any ordinary human being into a marketer is nothing but affiliate marketing. So any blogger, I can approach bloggers, I can give my links, like how Amazon can give links and bloggers can put Amazon links. If someone buys a product, bloggers will get what commission out of it. So this all comes under what customer acquisition, guys. So we are done with both free over, organic over. Now we pull the traffic to the website from SEO, local ads, social media, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, Quora, YouTube, direct mails, then paid Google ads, search ads, display ads, video ads, social media, and then affiliate marketing, influencer marketing, email marketing. From all these sources, what we did is we tried to pull the traffic to the website. Now what has happened is basically people are coming to the website. Let us assume people are coming to the site. Now, after people come into the site, people are coming to all these sites, e-commerce sites or blog, people are coming. Now, our first agenda, primary indicator, visitor is done. Now, what is our secondary indicator? We want people to click on this button, or people should what? Go to the contact us page and fill the query form. Or if it is Amazon website, they have to click on buy now button. Or it is a blog, we want people to click on the ads. Now, forget about the blog, we will discuss only about business. So people should either click on buy now button or people should fill the query form. Now, there are out of 1 lakh people who come to the website, only 10,000 people might go to contact us page, or only 10,000 people might buy the product. Less than 90,000 people, there is a chance that they might escape. Why will people escape from your website? Maybe on the Facebook, they saw the ad, they clicked on the ad. Your mom called, she's in kitchen. You went there, you forgot that you clicked on the ad. Now I lost money. You came, you left. Where is my 50 rupees per click? I lost 50 rupees. Now who will give that money back? So I need to again pull you back to my website. If I don't pull you back, I'll lose my money. What I'm doing, all the hard work that I'm doing. If people are coming here and if people leave, then it is a problem, right? Or your friend called, you opened my website to buy Dell laptop. You forgot, your friend is WhatsApping. Then you went to the WhatsApp chat. You forgot that you opened the website. Then gone, right? The traffic, I lost your traffic. Now how to pull again back the traffic? For that, we have a topic called nurturing the traffic, or converting visitors into customers. How do we do is we'll use a technique called remarketing. So what is mean by remarketing is basically we can do remarketing on display ads, video ads, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. So let me explain you what is mean by remarketing. So remarketing is nothing but you go to Amazon website, you go to Dell laptop page. You must have seen this. You go to Myntra, you add product in wishlist. Every day you'll be seeing those ads only. You go to Facebook, they'll follow. You go to Instagram, they'll follow. You go to YouTube, they'll follow. You go to Google also, they'll follow. Or you go to Amazon website, you don't buy the product and you run everywhere. The ads will keep on running again. I mean, wherever you go, they keep following you, right? So this is called remarketing in short. That means every day we people can remind you, come back. You left here, you come back. So that what is happening is we are not losing the traffic. Again, we are trying to pull the people back to the store. And that's called remarketing. How does this concept work? Let me show you. First, I'll write some conditions in marketing. If customer went to Amazon website, and if he had gone to Dell laptop page, and if he didn't go to thank you page, when will he not go to thank you page? That means he left in between. He didn't go to thank you page. If he didn't go to thank you page, then what I will do? Then show Dell laptop ads. This is how I'll write the condition. Any visitor who comes to Amazon website, if they go to Dell laptop page and if they don't go to thank you page, when will a thank you page come? Thank you page will come only after the payment gateway, after the complete payment process only. What will come? Thank you page will come. So if thank you page doesn't come, means that means this fellow came and he left in between. To him, what I will show every day, I'll keep showing Dell laptop ads. Wherever he goes, on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, everywhere, ads will follow. Finally, he might click and he might come back to the site. Next, one more example, let's take. If customer goes to Amazon site, and if he goes to Dell laptop page, and after going to Dell, laptop page, he must have gone to what you call thank you page as well. If he has gone to thank you page, that means he purchased even Dell laptop. Now what will happen, wherever I go, laptop bags will follow. That means I can cross sell. If a person purchases sofa, I can sell sofa covers. If a person purchases laptop, I can sell laptop bags. So like this, what I can do is I can do cross sell also. So remarketing will help people to bring customers back to the site. Next concept what we have is called drip campaigns. So what are drip campaigns basically is? Drip campaigns are nothing but daily, instead of directly asking a person to buy, for example, you're working for gym, let us assume, daily come and buy our gym membership, people will not come, they get irritated. So what you're supposed to do, daily send one email every day, 10 reasons why you should join our fitness center, 10 yoga practices to do, that, this, every day, this is what our testimonials, what people are talking about our gym. Every day you have to pamper your customers with what, through emails, or you can send push notifications. Push notifications are nothing but, you guys must have seen, right, in Instagram you get push notifications. So if you guys do this, then what will happen, daily the he gets nurtured, and then finally there is a chance that the customer might come back to the he might come back and he might buy the particular gym membership or product or whatsoever. So daily one email, smooth soothing emails daily, 10 reasons why you have to learn this course, what our customers are talking about our particular brand, our testimonials. I say you need to pamper him without any sales language, you should use marketing language. So once he gets pampered, then there is a chance that he'll only come back to you. So that's called drip campaign. So if you use drip and marketing, then the lead would get nurtured, and finally there's a chance that he might get converted. Now people are, now we saw that, let me go to a slide which says all. Now people are coming from organic, people are coming from inorganic, from all these sources people are coming to the website. If they miss, there are two chances. If the people are coming from free or paid, there are two chances. One, the customers might skip, or one, they might get converted. Whether they skip, what we guys are going to do, we are going to do remarketing, we'll run drip campaigns, and again there is a chance that he will visit the site. So the main agenda is, we need traffic to the website, we were pulling traffic. The traffic is being missed, again we are calling them back through what, remarketing campaigns. Now, if that fellow didn't miss, there's a chance that he might get converted. Now, if he is converted also, with one customer, we have to generate 10 more customers. How do we do that? We can give them exclusive discounts that you promote to someone. I'll give you this gift hamper, or I'll give you a link, you share it to your friends, then you'll get extra, discount. So all this, all this will come under what, customer delight. So if you can write nice articles to the customers, if you can create nice emails, and daily if you can send to your existing customers, these existing customers, what they will do is they'll tell their friends, and you can get more traffic to the website. Now, apart from the to see this entire hangama that is going on, to track all this, there's a tool called Google Analytics. So in Google Analytics, we people can track from which city people are coming, from which source people are coming, from which country people are coming, what age group people are coming to the website, what are they doing on the website. All this we people can track using what, Google Analytics. So I'll show you practically how Google Analytics works. Let me go to Google Analytics. Right, so this is my Google Analytics account. So you can see right now there is one user on the website. You will have real-time data. You can see what is happening on your website at real-time also. Right now there is one guy who is there on our website. So one second, let me go to the site. Right now, you guys, if you practically want to see right now from which country he is from, he is from Amsterdam. He is on my website right now. Even you people, what you people can do is in the chat box, I'm posting the URL. You can open the URL. You can type digitalnest.in. If you type digitalnest.in, what will happen? The traffic can grow here. See, you guys type this website digitalnest.in. You type. If you type digitalnest.in in the URL, what will happen? The traffic is growing. You can see right now the traffic is increasing. So you can see there are three people right now on this site. So it keeps what you call improving as you keep as most of the people keep logging into this site. See, now four we are able to see. So like this we can track how many people are there on this site also right now, how many people are there, what are they doing, on which page they are there. All this way people can track using what Google Analytics. Apart from this, in detail we also have two more options I'll show. So see, right now from Hyderabad 5 people are there, one guy from Amsterdam is there, one person came from Facebook to the site, two people came from Google to the site, but no keyword is provided. 6 people are there on the site right now, 7 people are there on the site. So like this live tracking, you people can see what is happening on the website. Apart from that, you can also see geo. Geo is nothing but location wise how people are behaving on the site. Mobile users, many options are there in Google Analytics, like from China how many people came, from Russia how many people came, from April 15 to April 20th what is the traffic, from United States 128 people came. Now what are these people doing? Indian people, you see 1721 people came to the site, 1.77 pages they visited, they spent 1 minute 27 seconds, and 52 people filled the query from India. But if you see United States, 128 people came, they are spending one or two pages they are visiting, but they are spending only 22 seconds and zero conversions. That means US people don't know what is the problem, but Indian people are behaving properly. So like this, you people can go and you can check, lot of options are available, you can go and you can check. So for example, devices, let me show you devices. See, Apple phone, iPhone people, how they are behaving. They are spending 1 minute time, but if you see Xiaomi people are spending only 44 seconds time. So you can see age, gender, location wise, browser, what kind of people are coming, all this you people can track using what you call Google Analytics. Right now we don't have time, so I have to rush forward. So Google Analytics, where you'll get the entire information about what is happening on your website. Right, so we are done with the complete digital marketing. Now let us get into the FAQs, and if you people are having anything, you can post in the question and answer box as well. Right, now why digital marketing? Digital marketing, you people can measure that. In TV and radio we people cannot measure, but Google Analytics may, where everything you can measure. Next, it's very low cost, you people can reach to a larger audience with cheaper cost. Next, you can reach targeted audience. Targeted audience is nothing but by age, gender, like we discussed in detail. Next, it has got resume, pause and edit options. For example, you commit any mistake in newspaper ad, you cannot take it back. But in digital marketing, you can pause, you can stop, you can edit if you know that. And again, you can restart your campaigns. Next, if you want to show ads only to midnight, only on Saturday and Sunday, only in the morning time, only in the afternoon time, if you want to show ads, you can also do that by using what scheduling option in digital marketing. What are the packages that a fresher get? Basically, between 10k to 30k is what companies are ready to pay for a fresher. Even if your communication skills are good or bad, people are ready to pay. These are the average packages in the market. Now, what kind of companies are hiring is, MNCs will hire, startups will hire. But 80% of the jobs in digital marketing will be in startups, because they will not have much funds to put their ads on TV or TV or radio or holdings. So what they will do is, they will invest on digital marketing because it's free of cost, or with cheaper cost, they can reach a larger audience. Next, MNCs, I already told you, Google, Accenture, Cognizant, Genpact, HCL, and few other companies. And apart from that, Make My Trip, Yatra, and all e-commerce people will hire you guys. Next, what are the certifications that are available in digital marketing? Google Ads has got 4 certifications. Google Fundamentals, Google Search, Google Mobile Ads, for all the ads topics that we have in Google Ads. Each and every ad topic is having a certification. So you people can get certified by Google. And we people at our institute help people to get certifications as well. Next, Microsoft Bing has got 1 certification that is also available. And Digital Nest has got 1 certification. So overall, there are 6 certifications. Next, if you look at some of the articles in newspaper, demand exceeds supply for jobs in digital marketing and artificial intelligence. Compensations are higher, but skills are short in supply. These are the 2 courses that are trending, 2 careers. One is data scientist or business analyst, which comes under data scientist. And second is digital marketing, because until and unless there is internet, data is generated from data to take decisions. Companies are appointing data scientists to automate their processor to take decisions. So where compensations are high but skills are short in supply, because this course is not available in the colleges or universities or whatsoever. So but the industry is looking forward. So as many people are not got trained on this, so there are a lot of openings on this particular careers actually. Next, homemakers generate 9 billion sale through WhatsApp is what study says. Next, 10 reasons why you should learn digital marketing. It's easy to learn. It's not a rocket science. It's as easy as operating a smartphone or playing a rummy game. It's equivalent to a mini MBA, like you'll be learning all the jargons as well. Next, from student, you can turn into what? Entrepreneur. If you people want to set up a business, all that you need is a Wi-Fi connection. You can sit at home and you people can start operating your business as well. Next, where are you guys? Nation demands digital marketers. There's a lot of supply and demand gap. So this, I extracted this image from memes.com. So I don't have any copyright over it. Okay. Next, it adds weightage to the resume. You can get one more skill set on your resume so that when you go to an interview, you can stand ahead in the competition. Next, the growth rate of digital marketing is very high. So you can also be a part of growth curve. You can stand ahead in the competition. So when you go to an interview, if you are having extra skill set, so there's a chance that you will be likely to be picked and to get more hike or salary. They need more. If you are having more skill set, there is a chance that job rotation can happen and you can take up managerial positions immediately if you are having this skill set. Next, you can be certified by Google. Next, it will not cost you lakhs, it will only cost you thousands. In fraction of 2 to 3 months, you people can learn it and you can start implementing on a live project as well. Next, you are future ready. Next, we at DigitalNest, we are 3 trainers. In Panjagutta branch, Mr. Subhash handles, Hightech City, Dani Manohar, and all the advanced sessions I will be handling. That is me, that is Sandeep Santosham. Next, our course fee and duration. Basically, the duration of our course is for 45 days. We have batches at 7 a.m., 11 a.m., 7 p.m., weekends, 3 p.m., 5 p.m. Also, we have batches in Hightech City and Panjagutta. Apart from that, we have online trainings as well, which will be for 45 days. We deliver it through Zoom or through Skype or through GoToMeeting application. And the batches are there in the morning, 7 a.m., 7 p.m., evening. And right now, because of lockdown, we are conducting complete online classes, and most of the people are buying e-learning recorded videos. All whenever we take a class, we record all the videos, so even you people at any point of time, any doubts you have, the trainers are available on WhatsApp to clarify your doubts. You can watch the videos and you can learn the course at any point of time. You have doubts, you can take screenshot and send to the trainers. We have a learning management system. All the recorded videos at any point of time for 45 days, you'll have access to the videos. So classroom, online and e-learning are the options for people who wants to enroll to the course at DigitalNest, in case if you are interested too. Next, generally the course fee of DigitalNest is 29,500. Right now we are giving general discount of 8,500 because of lockdown offer, and students get 11,500 off if they show the ID card as a proof copy. And we have a lockdown crash course going on, which will start on Friday. There's a batch intake on Friday. Monday to Sunday, daily 2.5 hours to 3 hours, we'll be taking classes and we'll be teaching complete digital marketing, which is practical hands-on certification, and we also help with internships and placements as well. Now, when it comes to the, if you are interested in taking e-learning or through recorded videos, so we have some special offers going on. Your blogging and website designing will cost you 1,000 rupees. And search engine optimization 3,000, Google AdWords with certification 8,000, social media marketing 5,000, email marketing 2,000, affiliate marketing 2,000, Google Analytics course 2,000. If you people want, you can go step by step. First, you can learn this, then this, then this, then this, and you can complete all the course. For every course that you people learn, you can get the certificate also, course completion certificate as well. Right, next, there's an exclusive discount coupon which I'll hand over to Rishi. Any of the students, if you people are planning to join our courses after lockdown, because this offer cannot be clubbed with right now offers, after lockdown, if you people want to join our trainings, 5,000 off, we will send to an email to you guys. You will find that coupon, take a screenshot and keep it with you. At any point of time in your life, anytime you come to our institute, you can get 5,000 off only exclusively for you. Right, so where are you guys? Nation demands digital marketers. Now it's your session. We are giving you 10 minutes time. You have any questions, you people can post in the question and answer. So that what I will do is I'm opening the question and answer session right now, and I'll be answering all your queries for next 5 to 10 minutes. Any questions? If you guys have, you can put in the question and answer box. I don't see any questions at the moment. If you have any questions, I'm ready to answer. So we are, if you have any questions, you can put in the form of, in the question and answer box, you can write your questions so that I can answer your questions. If not, then I'll move forward. So there is one question, is it student discount of 11,500 plus 5,000 for Badrukans? No, this 11,500, there's a question from someone, he's asking me, this discount of 11,500 plus 5,000 or is it separate? No, right now 11,500 is going for all the people. This 5,000 off you can get only after lockdown. That is separate discount and 11,500 is a separate discount. Right, any other queries or shall we move forward? If you guys are saying move forward, then we can move forward. Is social media marketing better for B2C or B2B business? There is a question from Venkatesh. Is social media marketing better for B2C or B2B business? It's better for both the businesses. See, you have to see your product. If your product is meant for a customer, you have to use Instagram, Facebook or Snapchat to market. If your product is meant for business, then you have to use LinkedIn to market, or you can use Quora, LinkedIn, where professionals are there. There you can market. So both are important. Social media marketing for B2C is important. Even for B2B is also important. Right. Any other queries? Any queries, or else we will end this session. Right, there is someone who is asking, tell in brief about affiliate marketing. So basically what is affiliate marketing is, so let me go to, so for example, you are a blogger, you are writing article about, let us assume, how to go to Goa. So you have collected information about trains, about flights, you are writing the content. So what you can do is you can partner with SpiceJet, or you can partner with Indigo, or for hotels you can partner with Oyo, or you can partner with Make My Trip. Now this website, when you take to the top in Google search, what will happen, a customer will come and he'll read this content. When he reads the content, I also stayed in this hotel, if you want you can also stay, Boleto, he'll click on this. After clicking on this, if he goes to Make My Trip and if he books the hotel, you'll be getting commission. Or you can partner with Amazon, you can partner with Myntra, you can partner with Flipkart, and you can put their ads on your website. If you put their ads on your website, if the audience are coming and if they click and if they buy the product, you will get commission. That is called affiliate marketing. That is one. Or else, as your blogger, you can put coupon codes, and if someone uses the coupon, you can get commission. Or you can put links. If someone clicks on the link and if they go and buy, they'll pay you commission. So all this comes under what? Affiliate marketing. Right, so next. So I'm done with this. Next question, do we need any tools for unpaid form of digital marketing? See, basically two or three tools are there in the market, where you people can use, but you need not have to pay them. There are many free tools where you people can use for digital marketing. Yeah, right. Okay, so we are done with this. Any further, we'll spend 10 seconds more. If you have any questions, you can, or else we'll end this session. We are still left with 2 more minutes. If you have any queries, you can post here, or we can close this session. Right, so I'm moving forward. So promise is what we make. So quality is what we deliver, job is what we ensure, and trust is what we conquer. With lot of energy, passion, commitment and quality, we have introduced digitalness to nurture young digital marketing professionals. So thank you guys for attending this session. So I would like to thank all the class representatives, Mr. Rishi, and the college management for giving us this particular session to help our students to know more about digital marketing. I think you people must have learned something new about CPC, CPV, what is search ad, what is display ad, what is in stream, in search, in display, and we gave you a lot of examples as well. I hope this session has enlightened you with new techniques and ideas. Now, what is the next step of processes? Once this particular session is done, you will receive an email and an SMS where you will find a feedback form link. You can submit the feedback form. Then that feedback will be shared with the management. And second, in that feedback form, you have to enter your mail ID and phone number and this details. Whoever enters, what we do is we'll give a participation certificate with the Google logo, and you can go and you can promote that. You can put on your LinkedIn or Instagram or Facebook or whatsoever, or on status update on WhatsApp, that you have attended this webinar. And this entire session is recorded. This recorded video, we'll upload it to YouTube, and that link will be shared to Mr. Rishi and all the class coordinators. They'll be posting that in the group. People whoever had missed can watch the complete recorded session as well. Right, Rishi, do you want to talk something? We are about to end. Do you want to talk something so that you can unmute yourself and you can talk? Right, Rishi, is there something that you wanted to say before we leave? Or yeah, I think in the chat you had posted. Fine. Thanks a lot, Sandeep, for giving real insights of digital marketing. On behalf of college management, once again, thank you for conducting webinar session to our students. Nothing else. Thanks. Okay, fine. Chalo. It was nice meeting you guys. So I'm ending the meeting. Hope you guys had learned something new today. Right. So how did the session go? A short, if you people can type in for next 10 seconds. Did you learn something new? If yes, then you can mention it in the chat and we'll end in next 10 seconds. Right, so done. Okay, I'm just closing the session. Thank you so much. See you. Have a great day. Stay safe and cheers for the day.